Hello friends, this is Professor Umesh and you are watching Made Easy Solutions. Today we are going to learn measuring units in digital electronics. Friends, you may ask me what is different in the measuring units of digital electronics. We know kilo, mega, no my friends. These are measuring units in decimal number system. Here in digital electronics, we use binary number system and base of binary number system is 2. So everything will be based on 2, not on 10. So kilo omega used in decimal number system are different than the kilo omega used in binary number system. So let's start with our today's video, which will elaborate you about the measuring units in digital electronics. So friends, as I told you in the introduction, just we are going to learn measuring units in digital electronics today. As we use binary number system in digital electronics, everything will be based on 2, not 10. So here in this video you are going to learn which type of measuring units we have in digital electronics. So let's move forward. So our very first measuring unit, basic measuring unit in digital electronics, is a bit. Just like in decimal, a basic measuring unit is unit itself. When we take 10 power 0, we get 1, any one digit, the digit which has a unit weight. So here in digital electronics, the unique symbol or unique digit used in binary number system is known as bit. You can see over here an individual digit or symbol used in a binary number system is known as bit. So which are these bits? Either 0 or 1. So a individual symbol, unique symbol digit in a binary number system is known as bit. So up till now, in previous video lectures, we used the word digit. Now in further lectures, we will use the word bit for a unique symbol used in binary number system. So here 0 and 1 are the two basic bits used in binary number system. Now let's move forward. As we have seen in decimal, that 10 power 1 is equal to 10, 10 power 2 is equal to 100, 10 power 3 is equal to 1000, that is kilo. Sometime you can call as a kilometer, means what? 1000 meter. So 10 power 3 is kilo. So similarly, we have some units in binary number system. One we have just seen, that is bit. So now what next we will see? A crumb. What crumb is? It is a pair of bits used in a binary number system. That means any two bits can form a crumb. So how many crumbs are possible? As it is a pair, so we can consider 2 power 2 is equal to 4. So 4 crumbs are possible. Which are these 4 crumbs? Let's see. Now as we are using 2 bits now, so bit 1 and bit 0, and now we will see the possible combinations. So let us consider bit 1 is 0 and bit 0 is also a 0. Now as we have seen while writing the binary numbers, when we use two sets, so we could write 2 power 2 is equal to 4 numbers we had seen in the video based on binary number system. So same case here, we are searching for possibilities. That means 2 power 2 is equal to 4 numbers I can write, that means 4 crumbs I can write over here. So what we will do now? Bit 0 will change, bit 1 will remain constant. So bit 1 is 0 and bit 0 is changed to 1. Remembering the concept of writing binary numbers, all the digits in set 0 are used. In that case, first digit of set 0 is used and kept constant until set 0 uses its final digit. Then set 0 digits are used again, and next digit in set 1 is used and kept constant until set 0 uses its final digit. This was the procedure we adopted while writing binary numbers. Same case here, that means here all the bits are used in set 0 and first bit of set 1 is used and kept constant. Now here as final bit is used, these two bits will be repeated again and here next bit will be used. So one should be over here. Let's see. 1 is there and then 0, then 1 and this 1. So thus total 4 possible combination is here, and these 4 possible combinations are known as crumbs. Pair of bits is known as crumb. So now let's move forward to learn the next unit. As we have seen a single bit, then a pair of bits, now we will see group of 4 bits. This is a nibble. Nibble is what? An aggregation of 4 bits used in
binary number system. Aggregation means group. That means group of a 4 bit in binary number system is known as a nibble. Now we know that if we use 4 digits in a binary number, we can represent the given binary number with its hex equivalent, because 2 power 4 is equal to 16, power 1 is equal to 16. That means when we write 4 digit binary number, maximum numbers I can write are 2 power 4 is equal to 16. When I use one set in hexadecimal number, then 16 power is equal to 16 hexadecimal numbers I can write. So each 4 digit binary number has its 1 digit equivalent hex digit. So same case here, a nibble is what? It is a group of 4 bits. That means a 4 bit binary number. So such 16 possible 4 bit binary numbers are there, and each has its equivalent hex digit. So a unique hex digit is known as a nibble. Just like a unique digit in binary number system is known as bit, a unique digit in hex number system is known as nibble, because it is represented, it can be represented by a 4 bit binary number as well. So let's see the possible 4 bit binary number and their equivalents, which are known as nibble. So all the possible 16 numbers are rolling down with their hex equivalents. This we have also seen in the video based on hexadecimal number system, or the videos based on convergence. So basically what? A 4 bit binary number is known as a nibble over here. So now let's move forward and let's see the next unit. The next unit is byte, and it is the aggregation of 8 bits used in a binary number system. So a unique symbol in binary number system is known as bit. Pair of bits is known as crumb, group of 4 bits is known as nibble, and now group of 8 bits is known as byte. So the possible bytes are 2 power 8 is equal to 256, and here it is not possible for me to write all 256 bytes. I have taken some examples. You can see here the examples rolling down, just one after each. Now if you have memorized the table of equivalence in all bases, then you will compare easily. That, see over here, 4 is nothing but 0100 in binary, 8 in hex is equal to 1000 in binary. You can see over AA, 1010 in binary, 1010 in binary. So if you have memorized the table, you will easily understand. And now you can see over here, as these are 8 bits, this can be represented by two nibbles, nibble 0 and nibble 1. So what a byte is? It is basically a group of 8 bits and a group of two nibbles. Now let's see what next we can say about byte. So it is a group of 8 bits, then it is a group of 4 crumbs as well, because pair forms a crumb. So here 8 bits are there, so 4 pairs are there, that means 4 crumbs are there, and it is also a group of 2 nibbles, just we have seen, that is nibble 0 and nibble 1. So now there is a method to read a byte. You can just read it as a byte, or when we have to read it in the form of nibbles, how can you read? See over here, I have taken the last number as an example. So when you read about 7, what you will say? Upper nibble of a byte. That means upper 4 bits, that is bit 7, bit 6, bit 5 and bit 4. You can see here, 7 is what? 0111, and F is what? 1111. So when I say about 7, it is a upper 4 bits, that means upper nibble. So 7 is what? It is a upper nibble of a byte, and F is what? Lower nibble of a byte, that means lower 4 bits, that is bit 3, bit 2, bit 1 and bit 0. So this is how we can read byte in the form of nibbles. You can read the byte in the form of crumbs as well. You can see here, we will consider the same example. So crumbs is what? 0, 1, this pair will form a first crumb, 1, 1 will form a second crumb, this 1, 1 will form a third crumb, and 1, 1 will form a fourth crumb. So how we can read this? A upper crumb of a upper nibble, because this is upper nibble of that byte. This 0, 1, 1 is a upper nibble of the given byte 7F. we have just seen. So 01 is the upper crumb of upper nibble of the given byte 7f. This 11 is a lower crumb of upper nibble of this byte. How we can read about this? This is upper crumb of a lower nibble of the given byte, and this is lower crumb of a lower nibble of a given byte. So this is how you can read byte in the form of crumbs or in the form of nibbles. So now let's move forward and see the next measuring unit. The next measuring unit is a word. Now what word is? It is an aggregation of 16 bits. That means double of byte. So now 2 power 16 is equal to 65,536 total possible words are there, which is just not possible for me, not for me, for anybody to write the 65,536 words on a single slide. So I have taken just an example. See over here, you can see bit number 15, 14, 13 up to 0, and this 16 bit word can also be represented in the form of nibbles. Now, as you know that nibble is a group of 4 bits, so this 16 bits can be represented by 4 nibbles of 4 bit each. So this 4 is nothing but 0, 1, 0, 0. This 7 is nothing but 0, 1, 1, 1. D is nothing but 1, 1, 0, 1. And E is nothing but 1, 1, 1, 0. So word is actually a group of 16 bits. So what more we can say about word is, it is a group of 16 bits, or it is a group of 8 crumbs, or it is a group of 4 nibbles, just we have seen over here. Then it is a group of 2 bytes also. So word can be represented by various methods, either in the form of bits, in the form of crumbs, in the form of nibbles, in the form of bytes. So there is a method to read a word. How you can read a word? I have an example for you. I have taken this CA9B as an example over here. So now this CA is what you can see over here, nibble 3 and nibble 2. That means these are 2 nibbles, that means these are 8 bits, that means this is a byte. So what you can say about CA? That CA is upper 8 bits, that means upper byte of a word. CA is what? Upper byte of a word, upper 8 bits, bit 15 to bit 8. You can see over here 1100 is a C and 1010 is a A. So CA is upper byte of a word, and then 9B is a lower byte of a word, that is lower 8 bits, bit 7 to bit 0. You can see over here 1001 is a 9 and 1011 is a B over here. So you can read it like upper byte of a word, lower byte of a word. You can read a word in the form of nibbles also. How you can read? Let's see. C is what? 1100, that is upper 4 bits of a byte, upper 4 bits of a upper byte, that means upper nibble of a upper byte of a word. And what about A? A is lower nibble of a upper byte. You can see over here, lower 4 bits, 1010, bit 11, bit 10, bit 9, bit 8. So it is actually a lower nibble of a upper byte. Similarly, what about 9? It is a upper nibble of a lower byte. And B is what? A lower nibble of a lower byte of a given word. You can read it in the form of crumb as well. So now let's move forward and learn next unit. Next unit is a D word, that is double of word. That means it is a group of 32 bits used in binary number system. So I have taken just one example because I cannot write such possible D words on a single slide. 2 power 32, you can imagine 65,536 multiplied by 65,536, such a huge number. Such D words are possible. So a single example I have taken over here, 32 bits, right from bit number 31 to 00 can be represented by 8 such nibbles, nibble 7 to nibble 0. CA9B47DE is actually a D word. What more you can say about D word is, it is a group of 32 bits, group of 16 crumbs, group of 8 nibbles. Just as I have shown you in the example, you can see over here, and group of 4 bytes and group of 2 words. You can read the given D word in various forms. You can read the D word in the form of words, in the form of bytes, in the form of nibbles. So let's try to read the given word. So CA9B is a upper word of given D word. 47DE is a lower word of given D word. You can read the given word in the form of bytes as well. CA is a upper byte of upper word of a given D word. 9B is a lower byte of a upper word of a given D word. 47 is a upper byte of a lower word of a given D word. And DE is a lower byte of a lower word of a given D word. You can read it in the form of nibbles also. So C is what? C is upper nibble of a upper byte of a upper word of a given D word. Lower nibble of a upper byte of a upper word of a given D word. 9 is upper nibble of a lower byte of a upper word of a given D word. B is lower nibble of a lower byte of a upper word of a given D word. 4 is upper nibble of a upper byte of a lower word of a given D word. 7 is lower nibble of a upper byte of a lower word of a given D word. D is upper nibble of a lower byte of a lower word of a given D word. And E is lower nibble of a lower byte of a lower word of a given D word. Confuse my friends? Don't bother, it is easy. As I am reading it, you can also read it. Don't worry. Don't be so confused. Don't bother. Just practice at home, because practice makes man perfect. Yet more to go. So let's see what is next. We have some big units as well, just like kilo, mega in a decimal number system. Here we have also some big units. An aggregation of more than 32 bits used in binary number system are referred as a big units. So let's see what type of big units we have. So let's start with small ones. So 2 power 1 is equal to 2, 2 bits are there. We have just seen 0 and 1. Then 2 power 2 is equal to 4 crumbs are there, 8 bits. So 8 bits forms 4 possible crumbs. We have just seen bit 0 and bit 1. So 2 power 4 is equal to 16 possible nibbles are there. Total 64 bits are there. 4 bits in each nibble. So 16 nibble consist of 64 bits, and such 16 possible combination is there in binary number system, and which are known as nibbles. 2 power 8 is equal to 256 byte. Total 2048 bits. 2 power 8 is equal to 256. So each 8 bit forms a byte, and such 256 bytes are possible in binary number system. Each byte consists of 8 bits. That's why 256 multiplied by 8, we get 2048 bits. So total 256 byte consists of total 2048 bits. Now 2 power 10 is equal to 1 kilobyte. Just like in decimal, we have 10 power 3 is equal to 1 kilo. Here 2 power 10 is equal to 1 kilobytes. And 1 kilo is not 1000, my friends. Here 10 power 3 is equal to 1000 we get in decimal number system, but here we are using binary number system and base is 2. So everything is in the powers of 2s. So here 2 power 10 is equal to 1024. You can see over here 1024 bytes, and each byte consists of 8 bits. So 1024 multiplied by 8 is equal to 8192 bits. So 1024 bytes consist of 8192 bits. So 1024 such bytes are known as 1 kilobyte here. Now let's see what next. 2 power 20, just like 10 power 6 in decimal number system, 10 power 6 is equal to 1 mega. Here 2 power 20 is equal to 1 megabyte. So this is actually 1024 kilobytes. that means 2 power multiplied by 2 power 10. So when we multiply same base with different powers, the powers get added to each other. So 2 power 10 multiplied by 2 power 10 is equal to 2 power 20, and 2 power 10 is equal to 1024. So 1024 multiplied by 1024 is equal to 1048576, such bytes are there in 1 megabytes. If you want to know the bits, multiply the given bytes with 8. You will get the number of bits in 1 megabyte. Tens, my friends, just 1 megabyte. Now, what do you say about memory card? If it is a 1 megabyte, what you will think about it? Very small. Is it very small? Just think about it. 1 megabyte consists of 1048576 bytes and 8 times bit again. So now let's move forward and see about next measuring unit. 2 power 30 is equal to 1 gigabyte, that is 1024 megabyte, that is 1048576 kilobyte. If you want to know the bytes, again multiply these kilobytes by 1024. Whatever answer is there, that are the number of bytes 1 gigabyte. I can show you by using the calculator. You can see over here 1048576 and again multiplied it by 1024. So can you read it? 107,37,41,824 such bytes are there in 1 gigabyte. If you want to know the number of bits, again multiply this byte by 8. So such huge bits are there in 1 gigabyte, and you are handling a 1 terabyte hard disks now. So can you consider how many number of bytes are there in a 1 TB hard disk? Just imagine. So we have seen 1 gigabyte. Now let's see what next. 2 power 40 is equal to 1 terabyte. That is such 1024 gigabyte and 1048576 megabytes. One more unit we have. It is not a stoppable one. 2 power 50 is equal to 1 petabyte. 1024 terabyte, that is equal to, and 1048576 gigabytes. So such big units we have in digital electronics. Okay, try to find out 1024 petabyte is known by what type of word. So what we can say about the units used in digital electronics? Let's say, so in digital electronics we use binary number system, not decimal, and hence everything has a base 2, not 10. Therefore here kilo represents 10 power 1 is equal to 1024, not 10 power 3 is equal to 1000. And mega represents 2 power 20 is equal to 1048576, not 10 power 6 is equal to 10 lakh, and so on. So we'll stop here. I hope all the measuring units used in digital electronics is now known to you very well. Press the like button if you like the video, share the video among friends, and subscribe my channel Made Easy Solutions. Thank you.